Jackman Abbey, and I'm here with my June 2016 Mon Ami Gabby Kit of the Month, and I am beyond excited about this. If anybody knows me or has been following me for any length of time, you guys will know that I am obsessed with Marina Leone, who's the owner of Mon Ami Gabby, and all of their projects, all of their different products that you can use on so many different types of projects. I have a complete playlist with just nothing but Mon Ami Gabby things I've purchased at prior conventions and things of that nature. So I have, I was asked by Marina to join her design team earlier this year with a combination of still recovering from my brain surgery and moving from Oregon to Florida. I am just now getting into where I'm settled enough to where I can start actually designing and making some wonderful projects and things for Marina and for the June kit. That's a Facebook group. And I will put a link in the description below as well as edit right here so you guys can know how to get to that, of course. So I'm really excited about it. So this is how your kit is going to come. It's going to be in this little white box here with your address information, of course. You open it up and then total Marina style. Even the packaging is just awesome. I love that she puts a sticker on the top so you know who it's coming from. I like to keep these because that's kind of person I am, and I love that the fact that it's wrapped in some really nice tissue paper that you can also reuse for future projects, because you never throw anything away if you're a real crafter. At least that's how I am. So I'm just going to go ahead and kind of pull this packaging out so I can get the box off to the side. And I'm filming on my kitchen counter. I have some white craft paper on the table on the counter, so I apologize if the lighting isn't up to par or where it should be. My craft room is not fully unpacked yet, so I just thought I would take a moment and go ahead and get this video done because I'm anxious to get started on making some projects for you guys. So here we go. We're going to see this together. I'm really excited. I have not been looking at any sneak peeks because I wanted to be surprised. Oh my gosh. Look at this beautifulness before me. I love it. And I'm not saying that because I'm on her design team, because I've been a fan of her since 2011. So I've loved her stuff for a long, long time. This is just beautiful. So just in the color scheme, I just love it. It just all looks so nice together. And what's inside here, let me grab it real quick before I lose it. This is just some of the different glue, like kind of like an adhesive, kind of like the Glubers. It's got some glitter on there from the other items within the kit, but you can kind of see these little squares right here. So the adhesive with Mon Ami Gabby is phenomenal. I've been using it and I love it. There's this really gorgeous butterfly right here. I have quite a few of these that I've purchased myself, which is probably going to be true with a lot of these things unless they're new releases, because like I told you, I'm such a huge fan of her designs and her company that my craft room is just full of that kind of stuff. So this is a gorgeous, gorgeous butterfly that you can use on so many different types of projects. I love it. And I'm anxious to look at this beautiful piece of trim. This is gorgeous. Oh my goodness, this is absolutely gorgeous. This is about 6 inches of this trim, and you can obviously make this go quite a long way by cutting this apart. You could use just this little strip here to add as an accent on a card or under flowers or something like that. And then you have this beautiful floral piece right here. Here's another piece where you could cut it apart if you could bring yourself to cut this apart. I know it's not always easy to do that because it took me a long time to be comfortable doing that myself because it's just so beautiful. I hate to do that, but you can really make your supplies go a long way if you do so. And there's this really beautiful bling that's throughout the trim. Just gorgeous. I love that. I'm already getting tons of ideas, which I won't share yet because I want it to be a surprise. So I'll let you guys just kind of come back and check those out. I love this trim here. I love this. I don't know the official name for this. I'll edit if I find it on the website and put it here. I apologize for that. I'm just taking a quick break from unpacking to do this video really quickly. So I didn't brief myself as I normally do, but it's stretchy. I love it. It's this really fun kind of a curl trim. I'll hold it up closer so you can kind of get a better visual of the texture on there. Love this. And you can also use your different sprays and mists to alter this to make it any color you choose. So you could really coordinate that for sure. These are some fun little kind of like goosebumpy kind of adhesive backed little like bits of bling, but they look like they have little goosebumps or look like little bits of candy. I like those, and I like that it's clear. You can also use your alcohol inks to color those. So I need to be quiet because I'm actually giving away some things I'm going to be doing. I'm sorry about that. I just love sharing different ways you can use these items in your crafting in case you're like, how do I use this stuff? You know, it's beautiful. I don't know how to use it in my crafting or to make a home decor. I'm going to help you with that. So this beautiful floral here, I love this. You could just attach this as a boutonniere or on the suit of your man or something like that, and it just looks so great all together. She is amazing with her floral skills. I am completely envious of that. She's amazing. I cannot arrange flowers real flowers anyway, to save my life. I'm very envious of that skill of hers. These are gorgeous. This is like felt, feels like, and it has like some string. You can see it really thin, kind of, what's that called? Like the thread, kind of like the little bits. I'm trying to hide my fingers because I have to get my nails done. I'm so sorry. It's not pleasant to look at. And that's beautiful. It's got like a little bead there in the center. This is really cute. And you get two of these in the kit. Really, really pretty. And I got mine kind of late because Marina was holding off until I got moved into our new house here in Florida from Oregon. So it's possible you've already seen this from the other design team members, and I apologize if that's the case. But just to kind of share on my channel, I love this. I got this in my design team package, actually, from her. I love this beaded trim that's looped into circles. So fun. And then I have quite the hoard stash of Marina's different paper flowers that she has. These are some gorgeous, kind of a really fun kind of a cream. And this is a really pretty kind of a cocoa color. I'm trying to get the camera to show here. Sorry, the lighting in my kitchen is not the best right now, so I apologize for that. So there are the different flowers. And those go a long way as well. And then here is some beaded, I think there might be two of them down here. Let me grab this one. Yeah, there's two of these here. It's kind of like some beaded trim on there, or not trim, excuse me, like little acrylic pieces. Really pretty. It kind of goes along the line of like her beaded acrylic sprays, the weed sprays. But these are like in little, you know, teardrop shape. So this is really gorgeous. And these are the types of things that you can add behind just like even a little bit of a flower cluster or anything just to kind of make it pop. I mean, you know, just to kind of give you a quick example, I suppose, you know, you could just really add something in between the flowers like that. This really makes these different embellishments pop, I think. So really excited to work with these. Love these little flowers that she has, that she makes out of her ribbon and trim. This is really cute. I love that. It's really detailed, and I love that texture. So cute. Love it, love it. This is some fun trim. I do not have this. I love this. This is like a checks kind of a box pattern, and I'll hold it up so you can kind of get a feel or look of the, not the feel. I wish you could get a feel of this. It's really nice and soft. It's got a really nice texture to it. I love that. This adds the perfect bit of texture or background on your projects. If you don't have like pattern paper or something like that, you could add this. It really gives a lot of visual interest to your projects. Here's some gorgeous lace. It's kind of like in a really nice kind of a cream antique white. I love that. You could totally, you know, cut this down the center, and then you have two strips. You could totally double your length of this lace if you cut it down the center. So really, really pretty. This makes some gorgeous flowers as well. I love this bling kind of trim she has that's on the plastic backing like this. I love this. This is so perfect to use to line cards, your outline of a layout page you're working on, you know, a gift tag, even some home decor pieces, which I'm really excited to work on, especially since we're in a new house here. So this will be a lot of fun to incorporate these items in that. I have some of this kind of glittery mesh. I love it. I'm glad to have more because you can never have enough. This also adds awesome texture to your projects. I love it. And what crafty person doesn't love glitter, right? Here's some white lace. Really pretty. This is always fun to use on the edge of your different projects as well. It looks great mixed in with your flowers that you make. Here, I almost didn't see these. This is so pretty. This is like, you know, some kind of like the floral filler. I like that. Not baby's breath, but I'm not sure what this is called because it's brown, but this is nice. And I got a really good sampling, so I like that. This also can add height and things to your projects too. Love this Chinese braid. This is gorgeous. I don't have any in the cream. So this is really pretty. I love that deep texture. Look at that. Just so beautiful. And it looks like I got about a 12 inches or so of that. So that's awesome. I can definitely use that. Here's some of their paper. Ooh, Abby, paper. I'm trying to remember the correct name. Like the paper twine, I believe, is what it is. The paper jute, maybe. I'll edit and put it right here. Sorry, guys. But this is really, really pretty. I love it. It's like a really nice basic to have. And yes, I think things like this are pretty because I see the possibilities in my head of how you can incorporate this. So I think this is just awesome. Love it. And we'll save the goodie bag for last, so I have a little surprise at the end. And this is some of her kind of like the glittery trim that she has. I'll hold these up together. This is kind of like a nice gold kind of maybe champagne-y kind of sparkle. And this one's more like a chocolate. Looks so pretty together. I love that. Love it. Adds such pizzazz to your projects. And then here's some of the bling mesh she has. I don't have any in this kind of gold color. That's nice. And that's the backside in case you're curious. You have a nice flat spot to use your adhesive dots or liquid adhesive if you want to, if you prefer that. And of course you can cut these apart and have individual pieces to use elsewhere. The center for flowers, things like that. Here's some of the pearl trim, which I have a lot of and I love it, that I've purchased myself, of course. This is some really fun kind of a cream colored pearl trim. I love it. Always fun to use in all your projects as well. And here's some of the gold trim. I love that too. You can see the detail in that. Adds a nice texture to your projects. And then this is so adorable. Look at this ribbon, or this this bit of a trim here. So it just says cute, and it's like some little bee right there, and it's got a couple flowers. Isn't that just so cute? I love it. This is adorable because you can cut this apart and just, you know, put this on the front of a card or underneath a photo or something like that, like in a, you know, Project Life or a smash book or a tag album or some kind of a mini or something, or just a regular scrapbook. You could put this underneath a photo, across the photo in the corner, something like that. So this is just another quick idea of how you could use this type of particular trim. And then, yeah, this one, the bee says cute. And this next one here, let's see. Oh, this is fun too. These are like some different stars and some fun circles. This is great to add some different levels of texture and pops of color as well. So that's fun. I'm glad to have that. And then here are some two pieces, if I can grab it without my nails. I've had my acrylic nails off for almost 2 months. I had to take them off because we were moving and I haven't found a new place yet. So I have trouble picking things up right now. So I apologize for that. These are some gorgeous, kind of like it. These almost look like, yeah, these are kind of like a, kind of a chocolatey gold kind of color. I like, almost like topazy, I guess is probably a better description. These are really fun to add in the centers of flowers as well. Get them off my fingers here. And then here's some of this really pretty kind of a two tri-toned satin, their satin cording that she has. I love that. All right, so now let's get to the little bag. And I love these little drawstring bags that come not only in the kits, but in my design team packages and different packs I've purchased off of, like their different, you know, Black Friday or their Facebook specials. I love it because you can reuse these and alter these bags. So I have some saved to the side for a future project to share with you using Mon Ami Gabby products. So I can show you how to do that if you don't know how. I'm going to dump these out, and I think what I'm going to do, so you can see them better, I'm going to grab this other piece of cardstock here, and I'm going to lay these out really quickly while I get them lined up on the card. I didn't do this ahead of time because I, of course, as I told you guys, I like to open this and reveal this with you on camera so we can kind of experience it together. So I apologize if this is taking just a little bit here, but I want to just kind of get them laid out just enough where you can kind of get an idea of what's in the kit here. And there is a lot in this little bling bag. I am really surprised. This is awesome. So this is a metal star. As you can see, this is actual metal and it's pretty thick. Probably I could actually bend this a little bit if I wanted to give this some dimension. But this is cute and it has a little loop at the top so you could put some cording through it and you could dangle it off of a photo, or if you're into jewelry, you could make this into some kind of a necklace or bracelet or something if you wanted, or even an earring, but you'd probably would need to. And look at this beautiful little mini brooch there with that pearl in the center. And then I got quite a few of these like white kind of iridescent shimmery buttons. These are awesome. You can run some cording or some thin jute through that and add it to a project. There's like some little resin flowers. There's all kinds of little metal embellishments in here. This is just amazing. Look at all these butterflies that are in here. Hopefully the lighting's okay. I'm sorry guys, I'm trying to hold it right. It's not my craft room's lighting setup right now. This is a diamond. That's cool. I could tape that to my wedding ring. Just kidding. And there's like some little pearl pieces here. I love that. Flowers there. And there's also some of the different sheer trim flowers. So this is a lot. And there's a corner piece right here too. This is a lot of metal embellishments in this kit. I'm really surprised with the quantity. I know the metal embellishments aren't always the cheapest. There's a few different Etsy shops and different places that I found over the past 20 something years that I've been crafting, but this, you know, and this is the first kit I've ever seen where you get this amount. This is a lot, and this is a fabulous deal, Marina. This is awesome. I could see this just as a piece on its own because there's so much in there. So this gives you so many different ways that you can incorporate different metal embellishments as texture and things of that nature into your kits. I think this is awesome, or excuse me, your different projects. So I'm really excited to start using these items into various different home decor items. I'm gonna have some different cards, some different paper crafting type of things, memory making things. I kind of craft all over the board. I'm not just a paper crafter or being, meaning I'm not just like a scrapbooker or just a card maker or whatever. I do mixed media, canvas work, all of that. I love it all. And I'm really excited to incorporate all these goodies in there. So I hope that you guys love this kit. I'll put all the information in the description bar below that lets you get to the Mon Ami Gabby website where you can sign up and purchase future monthly kits. Also on the Facebook group, I'll put a link to that to where you can join the Facebook group and you can see other people who purchase the kits, how they use the different items in their personal crafting, as well as the other design team members, including myself. We're going to be sharing our projects there as well as on my own YouTube channel for my own personal projects, so I can share with you all the different ways that you can use these wonderful products from Mon Ami Gabby. Marina, this is an awesome kit. I love it. Thank you so much for giving me the honor of being on your design team. I'm excited to craft and design for you. So if you have any questions or anything, please be sure to leave them in the comments below. Also follow me on Instagram. My name is just Scrappin' Abby everywhere for all my crafty stuff. I'm also going to have some sneak peeks of different projects and things that I post on Instagram that I don't put, you know, anywhere else first. That way you can kind of get little sneak peeks and ideas of what I'm kind of working on before I get the actual video created and put up on my YouTube channel. So if you kind of want to see what I'm working on before it gets to my channel, make sure you check me out on Instagram. Thanks so much, everybody. Happy crafting, happy planning, happy scrapping, and I'll see you next time. Bye!